In this screencast, we're going to demonstrate the use of the average molecular weight for a mixture to help simplify a problem. So here we're given a column and a composition of gases leaving the column. And if we were interested in the total volumetric flow out of this column for processes downstream, then we would need to calculate the molar flow from the column. And so to do that, we can either calculate the moles of each species and then the total amount of moles leaving the column, or we could calculate an average molecular weight. So let's do that, given information we've worked out in previous screencasts. So let's just reiterate what we're focusing on. If we have 50 kilograms per hour leaving the column, and we divide this by our average molecular weight of our mixture, and this is going to be in kilograms per kilomoles, then this will give us kilomoles per hour. So we need to figure out what our average molecular weight is. Now the equation we've worked out previously was that the reciprocal of the average molecular weight is equal to the summation of each mass fraction designated xi for each component divided by their molecular weights. And we're using this formula compared to the other one we've seen, which is the summation of the molar fractions times the molecular weights, because we're given a mass flow and this is a mass composition. So we're going to use this equation rather than the other one and start filling in what we know for each of these species. Now obviously you see we're going to need the molecular weight of each component, so I'm going to start looking those up and filling them in our table. So here are the molecular weights for each of the gas species, and we basically follow this equation where we take the mass fraction and divide it by its molecular weight, and then we sum all these up. So here's the summation of all my products, and this is going to be equal to 1 over the average molecular weight. Just looking at the chart, we look at our lowest molecular weight, which is 16, and our highest, which is 44. So we know our average has to be between these two values. So let's do these calculations, and you see that we get 0.04 moles of mixture per grams of mixture. And we know we need to take the reciprocal of this, and when we do so, we get an average molecular weight of 25.4 grams of our mixture per mole of our mixture. So what do we do with this? Well, we're going to go back to our original problem statement and take our 50 kilograms an hour and plug this in, making sure the units are correct, and we could calculate what our molar flow from the column is. And I get 1.97 kilomoles per hour exiting the column. So now that we've calculated the molar flow rate, we could use that to determine the volumetric flow rate by, say, using an ideal gas law. So another way to do this even quicker is if we use a spreadsheet. So let's open up Excel. I've typed in my species, the molecular weight of each species, and the mass percent. It's probably good practice to make sure that you entered everything in correctly, and so the mass percent should add up to 100. So if we wanted to calculate the average molecular weight given these mass percents and then have a spreadsheet that does it if we change the mass percents up, or we could also do it for a mole percent, then we need to enter in some equations. So the first thing we need to do is convert to mass fractions. So I would type in, say, mass frac, and then take each of these and divide by 100. Then we could use our formula. So I'll just type in formula and set this equal to our mass fraction divided by our molecular weight. Now we do this for each of them and we sum them up. We can then take the reciprocal of that and we have our molecular weight for this composition. Now the nice thing is, say I change oxygen to 10 and nitrogen to 28. It changes our average molecular weight slightly. Probably a good check is to keep our summation up to 100 so that we don't necessarily change one value and then realize that that would be an impossible composition. So now we have a spreadsheet that's built to calculate our average molecular weight given certain compositions and species. So you could do the same thing for a molar flow rate and have a similar looking spreadsheet.